Hi everyone, John from Wire here. In this video, we're going to learn how to automate cart recovery emails in Shopify using the free automation service offered through MailChimp. In order to begin, you need to first connect your MailChimp account to your Shopify store. I have another video that goes over how to do this step by step, and you can find a link to that video below in the video description. The first thing you want to do is log into your MailChimp account and click on the Create Campaign button. Click on Email on the left-hand side, and then select the Automated tab. There are many types of automation to choose from, but we are most interested in the e-commerce emails. Select Recover Abandoned Carts, and you'll be asked which store you want to use this integration with. For this example, I'm going to use a store that I've worked with before, but if you have multiple stores connected to your MailChimp account, click on the drop-down button to select the right one. Once you've chosen the right store you want to use, click on Begin. On this page, there will be multiple options that you can choose from for your email that will be sent to customers who have abandoned a cart. The first option will be who it's sent to and when. Click on Edit Recipients and you'll see that you have the option to select a different time frame from when a customer abandons a cart to when you send out the email. I like to select 24 hours because I found that anything shorter than that comes off as being too pushy, and the last thing I want to do is drive people away from my store. Click on Save when you're finished, and then we can click on the Edit from Name button to tweak the settings of the next section. You want to make sure that your from name is instantly recognizable, so I would recommend just using the name of your store. Make sure that you can access the email inbox of the email address you are entering in the next field, because customers might reply back if they have questions or need support. You don't want these emails they send to end up in an email inbox that doesn't belong to you, or even worse, an email inbox that doesn't exist at all. The next section is by far the most important part of your email. Your subject line can make or break whether someone will open the email, and because of this, we need to make sure that it's engaging and sparks interest if someone is browsing through their email inbox. For this reason, I like to use a combination of two things to draw attention to my cart recovery emails. The first thing I do is pose a question right in the subject line. A question like, "Still deciding?" does the trick and draws the reader in. The next thing I like to do is follow up with a clear and concise reason for the reader to open my email. In this example, I'm going to entice them with a 10% discount on their entire order. Don't worry if you can't offer a discount. You can simply use something like, "Your cart is waiting," or "Don't miss out." Both of these options will work. Using this combination of posing a question and following up with a value offering is a critical part of ensuring that your carts are recovered. It's also incredibly effective, and I've seen massive success in the stores that I've managed using this method. It's extremely rare for someone to add a product to their cart and then ignore an email that offers them 10% off their entire order. Click Save when you're finished, then click on the Edit Design button to dive into the email itself. I want to make it clear right off the bat. You want your customers to spend the least amount of time possible looking at this email. You want them to click on the Return to Checkout button and finishing purchasing the items in their cart. With that being said, do not make this email complex. Add your logo, add your discount code at the top, if you're going to use that method, and then change the Return to Checkout button to green. You really don't want to overthink this email. You just want people to head back and recover their cart. The first thing I'm going to do is change the text at the top of the email that is seen behind the subject line. I want to change this to something a bit more descriptive and say, "Don't forget these items in your cart," then click Save and Close. I'm now going to go and add my logo at the top, then add my discount code information in the text box below. You can edit each section by hovering over the section you want to edit and clicking the pencil icon. If you haven't already uploaded a photo of your logo to MailChimp like I have, you can click on the upload button in the upper right hand corner, or you can drag and drop a photo into this page. Once I've selected the photo that I want to use, I'm going to click on Insert, and then the photo will be shown in the body of the email. The product titles, pictures, and prices will auto-populate based on the items that the customer has in their cart. You don't need to worry about this section. Finally, I'm going to change my Return to Checkout button to green by clicking on the pencil icon, then navigating to the Style section, and finally clicking on the background color. Once I find the green color I want, I'm going to click on Save and Close, and then save my work. If you're happy with the content in the email, click on Preview and Test, and then Enter Preview Mode to see what the email will look like when it arrives in the customer's inbox. make sure you check to see what the email will look like on mobile devices as well. You want to make sure that there are no spelling errors and the photo you use for the header looks clear and visible. Click on the X in the upper right-hand corner and then click Save and Continue in the right-hand corner. We're back in the settings now, but we've completed everything we need to do. So click on Start Sending in the upper right-hand corner and then Start. Your emails will now be sent to people who have abandoned their carts. I hope this video helped, and if you have any questions, you can leave a comment in the section below. Thanks, and have a great day.